This video is aimed at people who, like me, know what their spectrum should contain and need to use Genie to get the activity of more than 10 nuclides from the spectrum. This video may also be useful for anyone who wishes to figure out sudden error messages in Genie. Let's say you have acquired a very complicated spectrum from a very high resolution germanium detector, but you know all of the potential nuclides that may be present and you know what are their decay gamma's energies as well. So you'll want to use Genie to analyze what are the peak areas from each gamma line, and therefore how many nuclides decay has the gamma detector picked up. This is the analysis sequence that I've chosen to do so. You may wish to change any step that you want, but the general idea and error messages remain the same. Step 1, peak locate library gamma m. Enter the library you've created. Step 2, peak area library gamma m. Step 3, efficiency correction standard. I chose the interpolated option because I have already calibrated the detector efficiency using MCNP and entered all the efficiency values using calibrate efficiency by entry. Step 4, final step, nuclide identification using NID with interference correction. Using a programming language of your choice, you can programmatically create autohotkey scripts so that autohotkey automatically enters data into the nuclide library editor for you. For example, this is the raw data that my Python script reads in to create autohotkey scripts, so that you can think of this screenshot as a condensed format of the .nlb files. Each of these highlighted lines represent a nuclide, and the numbers to their right are their half-lives and uncertainties on their half-lives. Each of these highlighted lines represent a gamma line, specifically its energy, uncertainty on energy, abundance, and uncertainty on abundance. The fifth number is a number that I call significance, which I'll come back to later. This won't be entered into the nuclide library editor. Now, there are two possible error messages that may arise when you enter too many nuclides into step 4 of the analysis process. The first being the too many nuclide lines for internal array error message. The second is the enigmatic ATBAH32954 error. Both has to do with finding too many matches in the spectrum. My guesses about these two error messages are that the ATBAH error message indicates Genie will have to include too many gamma lines in its output report. Therefore, it fails in step 4. For example, on the screen, I have highlighted 43 lines. If all 6 of these nuclides were found to be present in this spectrum by Genie, then it will print out all 43 lines in the report. But if Genie has to print out over 1024 lines, then it will fail in step 4 sporadically and prints the ATBAH error message. Meanwhile, the too many nuclide lines error is counterintuitively caused by having one nuclide containing too many lines. In this screenshot, you can see the quote-unquote widest nuclide is only 15 lines wide. But if the widest nuclide has more than 85 lines, then step 4 would sporadically print out the too many nuclide lines error message, and the process will fail. A safe bet is to keep all nuclides below 64 lines wide and the total number of lines to below 900. These two numbers are obtained by myself through trial and error and a bit of guessing, but if you stick to these numbers, 90% of the time your analysis procedure will work without any errors. The other 10% of the time, the ATBAH error still shows up, and there are no documentations about these errors. To hedge against these error messages, which can render your analysis report useless, I have created an elaborate system that ensures the .nlb files created falls within the size limit that I've set out earlier. Obviously, you would want to only trim away the least significant and least detectable lines from the .nlb files. I've chosen to use expected number of counts as my measure of significance. I use a Python script to trim away the least significant lines from the raw data until the widest nuclide doesn't exceed 64 lines wide and the total number of lines from all nuclides doesn't exceed 900. A different Python script is then used to convert the raw data into a .ahk script. And then using AutoHotkey, I let the computer enter all relevant data into the nuclide library editor automatically and save them as .nlb files. Then I perform the analysis procedure.